The Torah ends with which story? The last pasuk of Torah. What's the story? The message of the last words in Torah. You know what it is? Which every Jew likes to write the last letters of Torah. Not a sofer. Every Jew writes the last letter. Huh? The last word is Ayad HaChazaka, Sha'asa Moshe, that Moshe did, the strong hand of Moshe, that he did, Le'ainei Kol Yisrael. He did in front of all the Jewish people. What did he do with a strong hand? What did he do? Huh? The last letters, the last words of Torah is the Yad HaChazaka of Moshe. What did Moshe? Moshe went to do karate. What did he do? Judo? They broke the Luchot. The praise of Moshe Rabbeinu is he had a strong hand. He took the Luchot and broke it. אשר עשה משה, אשר, השם told him, אשריך, יישר כוח, יישר כוחך ששיברת. Thank you, משה, for breaking the לוחות. Wow. If you ask me, this is the worst thing a person could do. To take Hashem's Torah, this is the holiest thing in the world, in creation. And משה took the tablets and broke them. He took Hashem's Torah that Hashem gave him. Was all hand made by Hashem, and he broke it because he was angry. Who gave you permission to break it? If a person takes a Sefer Torah and tears it on the floor because he's angry, what are we going to do to him? Everybody is too fast. You know? No Jew would go and do this. There's no one Jew that is going to take a Sefer Torah and take it on the floor because he's angry. And here is much, much higher than Sefer Torah. The Luchot, the tablets of Hashem. And this is the last words of Torah. And then we begin Bereshit. Bereshit, Bara Elohim. All the jealousy of the world that begins in Bereshit. So what is the lesson of Torah? Huh? What do you think is the lesson that Moshe broke the Luchot and Hashem tells him, thank you very much. Never angry at him. He never got angry on him for this. Every other little thing, Hashem got angry. But this, Hashem said, okay. Didn't punish him. I think the answer is, I'll tell you a story. One time, we went, I don't know if you know, used to go in America, used to go in Pesach to a hotel and take hundreds of people to the hotel, Pesach. So one time we went in a hotel that wasn't so, some rooms weren't so good. Some rooms they show us, beautiful rooms, so we saw. But then when we got there in real Pesach, we found out that some rooms were not even completely furnished or whatever, built, I don't know, construction still, I don't know exactly what happened. In the middle of the Seder, I'm doing the Seder with the family, comes to me this person and yelling and saying that he cannot do Seder. You sit here and doing Seder with your family, I cannot do Seder. I say, why? Because I don't have a normal room. I want a nice room. I came all the way here. I cannot sit and do Seder with my family. Well, I said, what's the problem? You need a room? Here, this is my kids. Take my room. I have two rooms. One for me, one for the kids. We'll squeeze in one room. Take my room. Finish. He was very happy. He didn't go to do the Seder until he took all my stuff from my room and put it in the other room. So, made a whole balagan in the room. After he cleaned my room, he took all the stuff, he came to do the Seder. Very nice guy. But he was happy. He was happy. And I was happy too. I did the Seder and everything. Then the people around me and all the committee and everything, they said, how are you going to do this? How did you give him the keys? It's not normal. How could a whole big family gonna go in a small room with two beds? I said, it's only 10 days, 11 days. It's no big deal. It's not a whole lifetime. A few days. It's okay. We'll manage. One is going to sleep here, one is going to sleep, one is going to go to friends, one is going to go here, we're going to manage. And then I was telling other people, listen, how much would a person go and pay somebody to educate his children, to teach them lesson, real lesson of life, real midot? How much would the person do? Pay for somebody to have kids that willing to give up the bed, willing to share, willing to live all in one room. 12 people in one room. How many people would do this? To educate a child, they would be willing to sleep like this. You pay any money. I said, this guy did me a favor. He gave me a chinuch of my children for free. So I'm so happy that I'm able to do this, not because I'm cheap. I'm trying to be cheap. If you take all your family to one room because you want to be cheap, it's not so. That's also not a good lesson. Being cheap in the family, everybody on one of the on top of the other, it's not so fun, not so smart. But this is somehow came up that I was willing to be mevater. I'm mevater. I'm giving up my room for a good reason. For another Jew to be happy in Pesach. I'm supposed to pay him, really, for doing this to me. So I think this is what Hashem is really in this Torah. Hashem is always asking us to forgive and not to be jealous and give up. Give you, like Avraham Avinu, he gave up his house, his tent for everybody. He goes, he gets all this so much meat and so much food for guests, for people he doesn't know. And he runs to Sarah, do this, make cakes, make this, this one. Who is this people? Why would we be doing all this for? His guests. And that's how he taught Ishmael. Till today, Chachamim say Ishmael likes to have guests. The Bedouins, I don't know, the Arabs, they like to have guests, give them coffee and this. And it's true, till today. It's all because Avraham Avinu taught them a lesson. So Hashem, he is supposed to be the first one to show that even though the Torah is the most, most important thing, and he did it in his own hands, not like the world, he just spoke and it happened. Here, Vayechtov al haluchot, Hashem wrote himself, and he made it. He made the stone, he made him stone. And here comes Moshe Rabbeinu, he breaks it down, and Hashem says, you gave me a chance to show that I forgive. They could do Aigel, and they could break the luchot, and I forgive. So now I could ask from other people to forgive. So I think in family, it's the same. You want your children to forgive each other, to be mevater, not to be jealous of each other. You have to show between you and your mother, you and your brother, you and your husband, you're willing to give up your bed, you're willing to give up your sleep, and a lot of other things that we give up for other people, and this is how we really get the good chinuch of our children. We should be matzliach and have nachat to everybody from his children.
Questions? Giving up the bed, literally?
No, like
your kids kick you out of your bed, you give up your kids, out of your bed for your kids? Literally, or you can have
no. Like I said before, kids are not the kings. They have to know they're not the kings. We are the kings. So the king, it has to be a situation that it's like I said, you don't go to a room because you're cheap. That's not a reason. You're going to give your bed to your children just because they are the kings? They're not the kings. You're the king. But if there is a situation that comes up that you have to give up the bed, you do it b'simcha. And you don't show any regrets or something like this. It could be to your children, it could be to your husband, it could be to a friend, it could be something.
Can I just clarify something? I didn't understand. The whole concept of him breaking the law was that Hashem is forgiving him, that...
Hashem really was supposed to be angry at him. But Hashem says, Yishar kochacha sheshibarta. Thank you for breaking it. Because that's how I was able to show the world that even if you took my stuff and broke it, I forgived you. And this is what we have to show our kids. Sometimes somebody is going to break my stuff. I have a cup. I bought a cup, beautiful cup. Says something nice, right? I bought it specially, and my child went and broke it. Happened this Shabbat. Yeah? So, this is the time to teach him, what do you do when somebody breaks something that you own? He broke it by mistake. But this is just because it's mine, I'm supposed to go crazy? Don't worry, it's nothing. I go clean it up. Everything good, you didn't get hurt. Beautiful. But sometime when a person has his own car and somebody broke his car, bank his car, he's gonna go crazy. When he banged somebody else's car, well, what happened? Nothing. No. It's not, you don't see, nobody sees. That's okay. When his own car or somebody else's car, it's supposed to be the opposite. Okay, kol tov, sort of what.